Hi, I'm Grant Miller. I'm one of the founders of Replicated. So, if you're considering using Replicated to ship your SaaS application to your enterprise buyers behind their firewall, then one of the most important questions that you probably have is, what does the experience look like for my customer when they install and configure the application? So, that's what we're going to walk you through right now. And we're actually going to use one of our customers, Travis CI, and show you the experience of what it would look like for one of their buyers to install Travis behind the firewall. So Travis CI is a continuous integration tool that is cloud-based. So a little while ago, they actually decided to offer an enterprise version that could sit behind the firewall and connect with GitHub Enterprise, et cetera. So this application, the enterprise version, is actually powered by Replicated. So what we're going to do is show the experience of what their an enterprise IT buyer or VP engineering who's installing a private version of Travis CI would actually be doing. So the first step that you need to do is create a Linux server. So I'm just over here in Google Compute Engine, and I'm going to create a quick machine that kind of meets their requirements to use. So just needs a good amount of memory and needs to be 64-bit Linux. So I love trusty Ubuntu, so we're going to use that. And I'm going to click Create. So while that's creating, I'll talk you through the rest of the requirements, which are listed over here. So this is just the installation instructions, which would be sent to me by the Travis CI Enterprise team. So a Linux server, step one. We've got that now. Next thing is a Travis CI Enterprise license. This would have been sent to me along with these instructions by the Travis team. The next piece I need to do is have some ports opened up that are accessible from my local machine. These don't have to be exposed in the public internet, just accessible maybe over my private network. And the next bit is to make sure that you have an SSL cert and key. So it's important that for this installation that we actually have some DNS set up. So I've actually done that already. And I'm just going to assign this DNS to the machine that I just created. That way my SSL key and cert will all match up here. And then finally, we need to actually have a GitHub key and secret. So Travis, like I mentioned, connects into GitHub. So you need to have it a little app in order to make those two be able to talk. Okay. And finally, I said I'm going to be installing this at travistest2.replicated.com. I just want to show you here that there's nothing here yet. Doesn't exist. So the first part is step one, SSH into this machine. Okay. So I'm going to SSH into it right now. I'm just going to use Google's simple web-based SSH tool. And then I need to actually install, prepare this machine for the installation. So I can run this curl script, which is what I'm going to do. Or if I'm a little more concerned, I can follow these manual instructions, install the debs, et cetera. But I trust Travis that they provided me with, a lot of software here. So I'm going to just say that this curl script is safe to run. Okay, so this is going to be installing in the background. What it's actually doing, it's not installing any Travis packages. It's simply installing Docker, and then it's also installing the replicated daemons. So these are the pieces that run and enable replicated to manage your application. So let's give this another few seconds. And while we're doing that, we'll kind of move on to the next step here. Okay, so you can see it's actually completed its course here, so I can exit this window. Great. So now we need to access that server via HTTPS on port 8800. So I'm going to grab this IP address. Then I'm going to make sure that I do HTTPS. Oh, Chrome. We'll get a new window, Chrome. Great. So HTTPS and then ports 8800. Great. Hit enter. And as you can see, I was been prompted with this connection security warning. So luckily, we know that the next step is to proceed past this. So we're using a self-signed cert at this point just to enable the communication at first to encrypt it somewhat so it's not just going over HTTP. But I don't have to stick with that self-signed cert. I can actually type my host name in here and upload the SSL key and cert that I mentioned that I was going to use. So here's the key, and here's the cert. Great. So now these will be on my machine. They'll be served back to me. So now I actually know I have a trusted connection and not a an untrusted, insecure connection. So now we are currently on to step 6. That was fast. And we're going to upload the RLI file. So this is that piece that was provided to me by the Travis team when I purchased their enterprise license. So what this is doing, and actually this is the only part that ever comes to a replicated server where it just validates that that's a real license. And now I have the ability as the administrator of this tool to configure who can access the admin panel. So I can make it so that anybody can do it. If this machine's over my private network, maybe that's okay. I can put a simple password on it, or I can actually connect it into my LDAP or Active Directory server. So I'm just gonna put a password on this because I think security is important, but I don't have time to use LDAP. Okay, so now we're here on the configuration screen for Travis's application. And you see there's a handful of things we can do. We already know what our host name is. And I can actually continue to just upload these other SSL certs and keys that match that host name. I can also connect it into my GitHub account. So I mentioned that I created this application earlier. So this is what allows Travis to talk with GitHub and pull in my repos. And then I can check to make sure that works. Looks like it did. I can click save. And you know, I'll just go through a few other things that we have here too. So Travis has options that they can, you know, set up. You can get emails from Travis, so you can enable SMTP. I'm not going to do that, like I said, just because I just need a simple configuration. I'll click save. I'll go back to the dashboard. And the entire time we were actually doing that configuration, Replicated was in the background pulling these images and preparing the Travis CI images to be installed on this machine. So you can see we're most of the way there right now, but let's we can kind of have a quick peek around while we're waiting. So one of the important pieces is support. So we actually have this support page that shows you, it actually shows you what's going on with the container. So we can see that this is now up and running, but it also has support files that can be downloaded by your user, and then they can inspect those and send them back to you, and has many other functions that that we can explain in later videos. But as I mentioned, here we go. It looks like it started. So let's click the button. It looks like we've got some CPU usage and some memory being taken up. And we go here, and voila, we have a private version of Travis CI running in our Google Compute Engine instance here. And it's actually, you can see it's successfully connected to my GitHub account using those credentials that I put in. And in the next few seconds, this will pull in my repos and prepare the application. So what we've done here is we've actually taken a SaaS application. Now we're running a private version of it in about 7 minutes. All right. Thanks so much.